Loading the LifePort kidney transporter perfusion circuit. Remove the sterile perfusion circuit from its protective outer dust cover. Place the circuit either on a Mayo stand or a back table, wherever it's convenient to open in a sterile fashion. A person who is part of the scrubbed-in team will then remove the perfusion circuit, remove the paper tape securing the inner and outer lids to the perfusion circuit. Remove the inner organ cradle. At this time, perform an inspection of the perfusion circuit. Ensure nothing is cracked, broken, etc. A non-sterile person will then prepare the LifePort kidney transporter to receive the perfusion circuit by opening the spring latch arm, tubing raceway, and locking arm. The sterile person on the field will then place the perfusion circuit on the edge of the table in preparation to receive 1 liter of KPS1 preservation solution. Inner and outer lids are then replaced on the LifePort kidney transporter perfusion circuit. The circuit is then handed off of the sterile field to a non-sterile person for finalization of setup. Perfusion circuit is placed into the LifePort kidney transporter ice container at a 90 degree angle. Insert the tube frame into the U-clamps. The beige tubing is then placed over the pump head. The raceway is closed and the spring latch arm is locked. Apply slight pressure between the bubble detectors and close the locking arm. The pressure sensor cable is then installed. At this time, the unit can be powered on and it will go through a series of self-checks. Place the unit in wash mode to start the fluid flow into the perfusion circuit. Once the bubble trap is filled with solution and solution starts to come from the wash port back into the reservoir, using a slow 45 degree rotation, rotate the LifePort unit to expel any ancillary air that may be in the micron filter. Upon completion, replace the outer insulated cover on the LifePort unit to help with ice longevity.